गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विथ फंक्शनल री एजुकेशन। एज द नेम इट्सेल्फ सजेस्ट्स, व्हेनेवर अ पर्सन इज हैविंग एनी काइंड ऑफ फंक्शनल लिमिटेशंस इन हीज और हर डेली लाइफ ड्यू टू एनी डिसेबिलिटी और प्रॉब्लम्स एसोसिएटेड विथ न्यूरोलॉजिकल मस्क्यूलोस्केलेटल और अदर सिस्टम, we have to re-educate them so that they can perform the activities of their daily lives with minimum effort and maximum output. In this topic, we will be learning about transition from lying to sitting, and during these transitions, as we pass through various positions, we will look into the activities which can be performed on the mat or bed, and also we will be look into the activities for movement and stability at the floor level. Then in next step, we will try to re-educate the patient from sitting activities to progress to the gait activities, and throughout this we will be including lower limb and upper limb activities so that the person can perform activity during transitional positions as well as during sitting and gait. First, as we know, the functional re-education is designed to improve progressively the independence level of the patient. It is important to teach a helpless patient to turn into the bed, and progression of mat activities, as we have already discussed during PNF and postural evolution, they are basically designed upon the theme of normal development sequence of a human being. There are various PNF techniques and facilitation and inhibition techniques which can be used in conjunction with these mat activities to improve the functional status and make a progressive recovery from disability to a better life. First of all, transition from lying to sitting. First, we will learn about rolling from supine lying to side lying position. Supine lying position is a position of wider base of support and lower center of gravity, which is more stable as compared to side lying, where there is lesser surface area in contact with the ground or floor, as well as there is higher center of gravity. So we are moving from a position of stability to position of relative instability. Rolling requires total flexion with rotation, which is to be initiated by the head and neck, and it has to be led throughout the motion by the head and neck only. For example, we are considering rolling forward and to the left side from supine lying. Trunk rotation is facilitated by strong pull on the left hand, which is grasping at the side of the bed, and it pulls or retracts the shoulder to assist the trunk rotation. Right arm can assist by pulling or pushing or swinging across over the trunk and towards the left hip. In this image, we can see that the person is turning towards left side. The left arm is grasping the side of the bed and pulling the end so that the shoulder is going into retraction, whereas right hand is swinging across from right to left side and assisting in rotation of the upper and lower trunks. As we already said, the rolling is initiated and led by head and neck. In the initial stages, as the normal development process suggests, the person learns to roll as a log, as a whole. The full body rolls together simultaneously. But as and when the child becomes matured, the rolling is segmental. Different parts of body roll or turn towards the other side as segments. They work in a chain but not simultaneously. So we have to train the person. If segmental rolling is not possible for him or her, we have to train them in log rolling first, and then gradually we should progress to the segmental rolling. During this, the side towards which the person is turning, for our example it is left side, so it is left leg is hooked over the side of the bed and it can help rotation of trunk and pelvis by flexion and adduction at hip joint. Right knee, which is opposite from the side towards which we are rolling, is bent, flexed from hip and knee, and push or thrust is applied so that the right side pelvis and trunk is lifted and is assisted in rolling towards left side. To come back to the position of supine from side lying, or that is called reversal of movement, right arm is helping the movement by pushing or retraction, and the reversal has to be in a controlled manner. First the lower trunks comes down, then upper trunk, and last the head and neck. So this will help in gradual lowering of the body from side lying or position of relative instability from the supine or position of relative stability. Purpose and use of rolling from supine to side lying: they assist during nursing procedures such as bed making or inspection of the back for any kind of bed sores. The patient can perform the movement whenever he does want to perform the movement. He can get a different view of his surroundings by turning. He can ease the pressure on his back, or once the person is continuously lying in supine, there is development of stiffness of legs, so the person can roll back to the side lying position and can reduce the stiffness of legs by coming into a comfortable sleeping posture. It is one of the first component of integrated series of movements which will further lead to sitting position, and then will lead the patient out of the bed. Thus, rolling is a very basic and very important part of our mat activities. It is the initiation. It is the first step to coming out of the bed. That is why it is much important.